Every kid should have a creek. I had mine, a little silver stream that spilled through my grandmother's farm in central Georgia. Through the mystical chords of my memory, I can hear the closing wooden clack of her screen door already 5 yards behind me as I high-stepped it towards the freedom of the fields and woods. It was as joyful as eating ice cream on a hot day. The world was mine to discover and own then, an open book, the pages yet to be written 50-some years ago, discovering turtles and fish and oaks and brambles. They all made their mark on my future. Knowing nature steered me down the path to biology and towards a career in conservation. Not every child can have a creek, of course. And in this time, when our population is increasingly urbanized, the opportunity for youngsters to fully immerse themselves in nature is becoming increasingly difficult. Couple urbanization with the fact that children typically have a highly regimented schedule, and you can quickly see that engagement with the outdoors is not always the norm. Life without an appreciation for nature should be a concern for all people who love the outdoors. And I've tried to promote the appreciation of nature and conservation whenever possible. To that end, the first crew of young adults has just completed their rotation in the newly established Middle Rio Grande Urban Conservation Corps. The Corps is sponsored in partnership by the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, the National Park Service, the U.S. Forest Service, the Bureau of Indian Affairs, and hosted by the New Mexico-based Rocky Mountain Youth Corps. The Corps is comprised of a body of young people, ages 16 to 24, who for 10 weeks worked on projects in the Albuquerque area. They planted pollinator gardens, built erosion control structures to keep soil where it belongs, maintained hiking trails, and gave conservation and recreation presentations at the YMCA and community centers in the area. The program was much more than a job. Each teen was guided by a mentor who worked in the conservation profession. These young people were employed in their own backyard, the Middle Rio Grande Valley, the intersection of diverse biomes and people that is rich in both culture and natural history. Based on feedback, it seems that these budding conservationists likely acquired something essential to appreciating nature, a natural resource stewardship ethic. I expect many Corps participants to come back next summer, and ultimately, my hope is that they will apply for summer internships between college semesters to work in the conservation field and eventually become future conservation leaders. I consider our support of the Urban Conservation Corps as an investment in young people, just as conservation of natural resources is an investment in the future. Believe it or not, the student of today is just a few years away from being a grown, mature, socially immersed, and gainfully employed adult. No matter if they choose a trade or pursue academics, whether they labor by brain or brawn, it's most important that they come away from the core experience with a better understanding of nature and with an appreciation of what is all around them. And probably most importantly, they understand that they can affect the future by acquiring a sound stewardship ethic. My Creek inspired me to pursue conservation as a profession. By enabling our Middle Rio Grande Urban Conservation Corps participants to experience the synergy of nature, such as I did at my grandmother's creek, they will better understand that stewardship of natural things is simply an instinctive part of the human experience. And perhaps, by nurturing that conservation instinct, they will be inspired to become better citizens, appreciate our natural resource heritage, and potentially become the conservation leaders of tomorrow.